The time of the word of God. Praise the living God. Are you ready? Are you excited? I will tell you one thing why you must be excited. The Bible says everything will pass away. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
But the word of God will remain forever. You know everything you are going through right now has a beginning and has an end. Because of what? Because of what the word of God will do into your life. Because everything that you can see, everything that can happen, hallelujah, every beginning and every end. Right now I decree the end of whatever you are going through by the proclamation of this word of God into your life. Just receive it in Jesus' name. Because the word of God is what is set there forever. No sickness, no problem, no what happened. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beloved, today, by the grace of God and the privilege that I receive from you, we will read in the book of Luke, chapter 21. And we will read from 15 to 16. Luke chapter 21. Let us read from verse 15. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To verse 16. For I will give you a mouth. I will give you a word. And wisdom, which all your adversary will not be able to contradict or resist. You will be betrayed even by parents and brothers and relatives and friends, and they will put some of you to death. Verse 17. And you will be hated by all for my name's sake. But not a hair of your head shall perish, shall be lost. But your patience possess your soul. Hallelujah. That means you will stand firm and you will get what belongs to you. Can you shout praise? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is the word of God. The Lord Jesus wants to give you a mouth. You know, when he gives you a mouth, it's to speak. He wants to give you a word that will speak. A wisdom. How you will do things. Whatever you know. How you will apply it. You know, because of the word that will speak. Because of what you will do. The Bible says there is no adversary. That means there is no opposition. Tell your neighbor there is no enemy. There is no witches. There is no opposition. Let me tell you. You know that you are going at the end of the year. Those they think that is delayed to do whatever they
want.
They feel excited that they can do because they still have some more
time.
But the Bible says, because of the word that you speak, because your mouth will express. And the way you will do things, not according to the wisdom of men, but according to the wisdom that comes from above, where there is no shadow or variation of turning back. The Bible is very clear, and you will see. Nothing will contradict you. You have to learn to speak it properly. Hallelujah. Amen. You must learn to pray properly. I'm teaching someone to speak properly. To pray properly. Because the more you do that, there is no adversary. There is nothing that can contradict you. Hallelujah. You know, this word come after when we go back on the first scriptures, on the first verse. Hallelujah. We will see something that is happening there. Hallelujah. In Luke chapter 21. Very, very important. We will start from verse 7. And they asked him, saying, Teacher, but where will these things be? And what sign will be there when these things are about to take place? And he said, Take heed, do not be deceived. Jesus said, Be careful. Put all your attention not to be deceived. Be careful in what I'm saying right now. For many will come in my name saying, I am I in Jesus. And the time is gone near, therefore, don't go after them, don't follow them. But when you hear of war and commotion, don't be afraid, don't be terrified. For these things must come to pass first, but the end will not come immediately. Then he said to them, Nation will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. There will be great earthquake in various places, and famine and pestilence, and there will be fearful sight and great sign from heaven. But before all these things, they will lay their hand on you and persecute you, delivering you up to the synagogue and prison. You'll be brought before king and ruler for my name's sake. But it will turn out for you as an occasion for witnesses. Let me tell you, beloved. You know, in this last time, we must be very, very careful. Let me tell you, the famine that you are seeing is not an easy thing. You have to understand something. Because in the end, in the last time before the end came, you can like it or not, family will be there. The Bible says there will be war. Nation will rise against nation. Kingdom against kingdom. You know, in the end time, let me tell you, the Bible continues to say, you will be persecuted because of Jesus' name. People, they will reject you. They will forsake you. They will hate you. Listen to me very carefully. If you are a Christian, don't think all people they will applaud you. will hate you. They will be against you. They will persecute you. Hallelujah. The Bible even goes sometimes far. He said, there is others, even their parents, their relatives, their friends. Who has a friend here? The Bible is speaking here. Even the one you call so friend. If your husband is your best friend, if your wife is your best friend, the Bible is even those, the relative one. Be careful. That means if you don't know how to stay in this end time, let me tell you, you can like it or not, you can be destroyed. Because if your own parents, if their relatives, if your brothers, if your friends can stand against you, but there is someone. There is someone. Jesus. Let me tell you. People they can forsake you. People they can abandon you. But Jesus. Jesus we are saying. We'll never forsake you. We'll never hate you. We'll never reject you. No matter what. Can you stand up and approach? You know, when I'm preaching, I want the Jesus to be your vision. Hallelujah. Because we must operate and function according to the head. And Jesus is the head of the body. Hallelujah. That thing is the best place. The Bible says he will never leave you. He will never forsake you. He says so. In the book of Matthew, chapter 28, the last scripture. Hallelujah. I think verse 20. Jesus is very, very clear. He said, I will be always. There is no even condition. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes it's a mass. When many people they want it, if he says, he says, I will be always. That means you are the one who refuses. Because he said, I will be always. Hallelujah. He did not say only about himself. He didn't say about the Spirit of God. In John chapter 14, verse 16. How long the Spirit of God will abide with you, my fellow brethren? Hallelujah. The Bible says forever. You know, this is the new. You're supposed to be excited. That means when I walk, I am not alone. There is someone who takes a decision, who accepts, even the friends that abandon me. The word of God, sealed by the blood of Jesus, he will never leave me. He will never forsake me. He will be with me. That is the guarantee. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, that promise is like those wedding marriage people do. They say, no matter what, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. That means in any situation. You know, the Lord Jesus will save you. He never, ever had an intention to leave you. The Bible says, even if he has 100, when one gets lost, went for that lost one. I'm preaching to someone right now. You can think that you have been lost. You have been backslided. That means there is no life for you. Because one day you start with him. In his plan, in his intention, he will never like to leave you. That means wherever you are right now, he wants to reach you to bring back to life, that you may enjoy again what he has prepared. You can be tired, you cannot make it, but he took already that decision. Hallelujah. I never saw any backslider people to be well, because when you get lost, you will be tormented. That's why it's the best way for you to come back to him. I'd like you to have that vision of Jesus in every area of your life. I'd like you to get that vision. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, Proverbs 29,
verse 18.
The Bible is very, very clear. The Bible says, without a vision, people perish. That means many people that are perishing, they have been destroyed, they are in the way of dying because they don't have a vision. If you are in marriage, before you go in the marriage, you have to have a vision for the marriage. And when you lost that vision, let me, I can tell you, because you like the vision that's there for your wife, for your husband, for whatever, for your family. That means it's a big invitation for death coming, for destruction coming in your marriage. Someone is following me. Because what we call death is when someone is not long for vision anymore. It's when someone is not long for his call anymore. It's not the one who is working in purpose anymore. If your purpose, you're supposed to do this and that, you are not working in that anymore. Are you following me? If you suppose you have been called for a purpose, you are not doing it. You have a vision. You say, when I will be married, when I will be Christian, I will walk with Jesus. And you are not walking in that. Even you are not dead yet, you are in your way of dying. But you can stop that when you repent and you come back to that vision. Why did you come one day to church? Maybe you came to play, but you meet
him.
That's why you continue to come. If you can keep that picture, if you can keep that vision,
even
when you are coming to church, you have been sick, barren, I don't know what. The Lord command me parents that I will sing song. Because the children of parents, they will be many. I get that picture. I know in truth, in the secret I'm going to
do.
He's the one who will kill me. I get that picture. If you maintain to walk in that picture, in that vision, let me tell you, then you will be alive. Then those things will continue to happen. But when you forget about that vision, you are not working in your healing anymore. You are not working in your fruitfulness anymore. You are not working in what you're supposed to be. I can explain to you, according to that scripture, without vision, people will perish. People, they will like strength. That is not good. And when you can like strength in the time of your adversity, you will die. Are you understanding me? In this period of time, when even friend and parent can be against you, when famine will be there, when the sickness, disease will be there, church of God, we must be careful. We must be careful. And the Bible says that when you come back, it will give you a mark. Hallelujah. That means in whatever you can go, don't be afraid. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't be terrified. All those things will come in order to terrify you. Are you understanding me?
Amen.
Life will come to terrify you. Family will come to terrify you. But when you know that these things cannot move me, I'm the one who will move them. You must have to do something. I want to raise someone who will be like David. Let us go in the book of Psalm 27. Hallelujah. Psalm 27. From verse 1. We will read something that is very, very important. Hallelujah. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Psalm 27. Follow carefully. The Bible, this was David. He said, the Lord is my life and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Who is the Lord for you? I'm not talking about the pastor. I'm not talking about the denomination. Is Jesus the Lord of your life? If you can say, yeah, the Bible says, is your light. That means in any darkness, you can go. If you can take the picture, that calling is calling. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Light will start to shine upon your life. And the Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall be afraid? It's not about the might that you have, your strength. It must be the strength of your family. Not yourself, not your money, not your talent, what you know. Oh, I know many people, I have a lot of relations. The Bible said, he must be, until you make him to be your strength, until you make him to be your life, in the time you are going to do, you will continue to survive. I can tell you. The Bible continues. When the wicked come against me, to eat up my flesh, because they are waiting to eat you before New Year. When they will come, listen to me. What the Bible says, not they want you down, your business down, your money down, your life down. The Bible says, when the wicked come, I just need to eat up my flesh. My enemy and fool, they stumble and fail. Can you shout that all enemies of your life will fail? In the name of Jesus, it can be in the business. It can mean whatever
you want.
Their plan will be for it and without any effect. Come from God. God knows it more than anything. Hallelujah. Stop an army. The Bible talks about an army. May he come against me. Listen to me. If a friend can be against you, here the Bible is talking about the army. If an arm cannot do nothing, what a friend can do? Oh my God! The one who ate you, what he can do? If the arm came against you, my heart shall not care. Let me tell you. You know, fear belong to the devil. Is where fear came. Because he knows where he's going in fire. Always you see fear is the one who brings fear. Because the spirit that we receive from God, the Bible says it's not the spirit of fear. No matter what, it's the spirit of strength. The Lord is your strength. Anytime you see the indication that the devil is looking about how to penetrate, but the Lord who saved you, who bring you out, he command you, no matter what you are going through, don't fear. Because when you let that fear, he will come in and you will be schooled. You know the enemy when it arrives you, it already gets victory over you. But when he came, it arrived. He said, you are standing. You say, no, you will never play with me. I will beat you back. He will flee. Because you are resisting him. But when he saw you, you see, what will happen? That is finished. God wants you to be strong. Child of God, no matter the attack, no matter the level of the enemy, we must learn to stand. Hallelujah. From God we did not receive fear. From God we receive faith. Hallelujah. And faith is telling us, no matter what, we will never go back. We will go forward. Hallelujah. Anytime you start to see fear in anything, that means the devil is trying to get it. And God is telling us, according to Ephesians chapter 4, 27, never give access to the devil. He can enter through fear. You know, when Peter was afraid, he was afraid because of the situation. Instead of seeing the light, Jesus and moving, he was operating in a supernatural way. But when he started to see the situation, fear started to come. What happened to him? He started to see. Anytime you are fearing too much, you will see. The things that you fear will start to happen to you. You must refuse to fear. And you can refuse to sin and whatever. Because they are cooperating with them. Refuse them completely. Hallelujah. Don't war may rise against me. In this I will be confident. Listen verse 4 what the Bible says. One thing I have desire of the Lord, that I see. May dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Listen, in the midst of what want to panic you, want to terrify you, the lesson that you can read, he said one thing, not two, not three, not four, but one thing. Hallelujah. In desire. What does he want to come? When the enemy attacks, when witches want to raise, when the situation is not normal, when your family is there, one thing you like, tell your neighbor one thing. Hallelujah. Is to seek the face of the Lord and to dwell in the arms of the Lord. Hallelujah. One thing is to seek who? To seek the Lord. To have the picture of Jesus. To have the picture of Jesus. In any situation, you can go to. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You must try to seek
Him.
This thing is not going well anymore. You know the song that we sing here. He has to be your lawyer. Without paying the fees. Why are you standing? There is no stagnation. To God they come to Him. God they come to seek Him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Bible says that I may dwell. Let me tell you, you are not seeking God to go. You are seeking God to dwell in His house. There are many people they come to seek and go. When you seek, you go. You will find the devil there waiting. Your security, your guarantee. Your neighbor dwell in the arms of the Lord. That's why when we come in a such place like this, hallelujah, we come to seek Him. We don't come to seek a pastor. We don't come to seek title. Are you following me? We come to seek who? Jesus, the Lord of Lords, the King of Glory. And we may dwell in the house. That means we must have a dwelling. That's why, you know, to have a place like this, you must be excited. It's not the plan of God. People, we have a place we can celebrate. Because the Bible is very clear.
It
says where to agree in prayer. To ask anything, it will be done. Let me tell you, when you can find at least two people, they are praying. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says it's in the midst of them. That means that will be a best place. I cannot understand how people even in our community, they can find people that are praying. Anyone who is afraid with the people that are praying, I don't know which kind of spirit he has. I don't think it's the spirit of God. Because if the spirit of God, those people are supposed to be
happy.
I'm not only talking about belonging to this church. But if you are a Christian, that means for you, even one day to come in a church like this, you become a problem. I don't know what kind of
spirit
you
have.
You are not even a pastor yet. Even if the pastor will go to other churches, who are you? Are you understanding me? That is not the spirit of God. In this last time, those they hate, following me very well, they are not from God. Are you understanding me? Those who hate, they are not from God. There are people that will hate us. Hallelujah. But at least we have Jesus. They can do whatever they want. They can make company. know, every time there is a persecution, the disciples they're supposed to know to go back to their
kingdom.
That means every time there are a bad
priest
want to kill us, the enemy,
they're
supposed to come back. You know, a such place like this is a dangerous place. Hallelujah. It will be impossible for you always to come here and disappear into your life. They will know you are coming in a
place.
There is a spirit for coming together in a place. The Lord Himself is there.
You will be
with all your problems. Are you understanding? This world can be against. Family can be there. But the best place to be is to seek one, is to seek the Lord, to come to dwell. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you come to dwell, is to behold the beauty of the law. That means you are coming to look on him, behold. That means to take his image, to make it be yours. It's what we call the awe. That means I get his picture, I get his life, I must be like him. I'm coming to change, I'm coming to see him, that I may dwell, I may be like him. Hallelujah. I may be like him. You must be like Jesus. Are you understanding? You must be all his beauty. You must pray that the beauty of God has started to be displayed in your
family.
The beauty of the Lord Jesus, the beauty of God has started to come in your family, has started to come in your life. The beauty of the Lord. And the Bible says to inquire. That means the best place to inquire is not really in your house. It's here. I know we can pray everywhere. But the inquiry in a such place like this is very different. Do you know that? It's very, very different. That's why it's a blessing to every house of the Lord. Are you understanding? Even right now we are renting. But because we have a place. You know, anytime when you are renting a taxi, especially when you need a taxi too much, what will be the end? You have to buy your own. Because after the end, if you can relate what you are renting, it will be too much. You rent a taxi because when you are there, it's like yours. But when you are not there, it's not like yours. But when you have your own car, it's different. You know, when you are coming in a place like this, we must have that picture. It's not bad to rent for a place. But in our mind, if we are renting in such place like this, we must put in our mind that at least one day we have to have a house. Are you understanding me? We have to have a house. Hallelujah. You are renting, let me
see.
If you can calculate the years. If I was just trying to calculate. If every month we can get at least 200 euros. That you can put aside. After 5 years. Do you know how much money you can get?
It's
the money that can get us to the
place.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It can seem like small. The problem is what? We are renting and there is nothing left. Pay nothing left. That is when you pay nothing. That is not wisdom. God is giving us the wisdom. Are you understanding? It's not like renting. The type of renting must be a time to invest inside what will make your future better. And I know with God, because of the wisdom. can contradict us, nothing that can resist us. Because the Lord we are saying is the King of glory. Hallelujah. He's waiting. You know, many times the King, what we have is only that small that we have. You know, there are many people that think I will never do something until I will see things. Even when you have that too, start to think that too. That has been doubted. It's been doubted. And after a while, you will be amazed. How much money even you have. Don't neglect small beginning. Are you understanding? Don't neglect about
that.
Even it can be small. Let us keep it serious. You know, David was someone that David liked the house of God. He even decided to build the house of God. Because he did not want to stay in his house. Because you know, if I stay in my house, I can't even be there anymore. But if I can build the house of God, the kingdom. That means with our time, with everything, we are building the house of God. You know, when we are building the house of God, by coming together, the Bible says we can inquire. Let me tell you, anytime we come together, like this, don't minimize the time we are telling you, pray. You are seeing like you are praying. We are not playing here. Most of the time is what happens. This is why you are not able to pray. That's why you need help. Many people, they are not honest. You can tell them to call Jesus, they can't. When you tell them they have a demon, they say, I don't have one. If you don't have a demon, why you cannot call Jesus? Why you cannot praise God? Let me tell you, you cannot come in the presence of God. You are so weak, you think you are full of yourself. God has called you young, but you are not operating the way you operate. Can you remember when Lazarus called him? Jesus called him, come out! Lazarus, come out. He was jumping
out.
The Bible says he was bound. He received the call, but he was bound. And Jesus said, listen,
yes,
because this is not the way of praying. Someone can pray like that. We need those people that are praying. Hallelujah. If you are praying, you are like
this.
God is calling you. God is calling you. That is the true indication that you are not free. Because God, they are free. Oh, God, they are free. God, they are free. They don't mind who was there. They don't mind the food they wear. They don't mind their beauty. Even the makeup go on. They say, I'm free. This is my time. Let my body and my
beautiful.
And very, very powerful. Psalm 34.
Psalm 34.
The Bible is very clear. Verse 4, the Bible says, I will seek the Lord and he will hear me.
You
don't seek him. How can he hear you? Hallelujah. Seek him and you will hear him. And he will hear you and deliver you from all the fear. Hallelujah. I see someone get delivered from that persecution. I see someone get delivered from the fear of death. I can see someone. Those they can come to church to see God. Not to see boyfriend or girlfriend. Listen to me. Those they are coming to see the Lord. God will hear them. No matter in any problem. I just come to seek my God. Because this is the place. You have people that can distract you. And you will remain bound for
it.
Hallelujah. He said, me, I will come to seek my God. Because there is a prayer. I will come to call the name of God. I need to come out. I cannot remain in this situation. My business is not going away. My money is not going away. No! I come to seek him. Come to seek pastor here. Just come to seek the Lord. I can hear you, but I'm very limited. But if we can hear you, oh, you know where Anna gets his answer. After many years of violence, she was praying at all. She was praying at all. But when they went, she was in the house of God. In the house, we have seen him. No matter the delay, they even forget about that. But one thing I like about God, God visit them. He visit them where? In the house where they dwell. There were priests working there. Do you know in the house of God, you will get the name of your child? And you know they get the name of their child. On a TV, stop giving your children the name that I'm giving. If you are a believer, oh, the name of your child must come. It was when God appeared, he said, the son that you will bear, his name will be God. Change. You will find the special gift. It was when Elizabeth received in the instruction. He said, my boy, he will never drink. Hallelujah.
Amen.
She received the instruction.
It was when
in the house. Listen to me. If you think what they give you advice in the party is what can make your life and the life of your children, shame of you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's only the instruction that come in the house like this. It's only names that come in the house like this. It's only what comes when we inquire, we ask the Lord. It's what will make your life, the life of your family, the life of your children better. And the Bible says his name will be great in the sight of God. You can see that in the book of Luke chapter 1 from verse 15. You go down. You know, he will be great in the sight of God. heart. Hallelujah. In the eyes of God. You know, sometimes people they can see you. That this is a small pastor. That is a small church. But when you want to look at us, he says, no, no. By God, it's what is happening right now because you are in the house of the Lord. It's what is happening when you accept to dwell, when you accept to come, when you accept to inquire. Anytime you are going through trouble, it's the best time. You come to be old. This is what the verse 5 says. They looked to him and were radiant. Looking not to pastor but to Jesus, your face will never be ashamed. Let that devil, if you die again with me, you will see. I will buy 10,000 than what I'm supposed to buy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You must say it because you are not looking to anybody. You are looking to Jesus. You will receive the radiance that can come from Him. This is what the Bible continues to say. Hallelujah. These poor men cry out, and the Lord hear
him
and save
him
out of all his trouble. I don't know about your trouble. I just come to preach this
way.
If you are going through any trouble, you cry. Let me tell you, you cry to God. Your prayer to God. God will save you. God will visit you. A day like this, you will never go the same way. If at least you learn to cry out from your poverty, from your trouble. Papa God is working. The Holy Spirit is working. Stop laziness. Open your mouth. Because God is giving you a mouth to pray. God is giving you your mouth to pray. A wisdom. How we can come together like this. Inquire is the wisdom. Hallelujah. This is the wisdom of God. God is giving to you right now. It's a free of charge. I can tell you, it's free of charge. I'm here to finish, beloved. Are you ready to use your mouth? Can you shout pray? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Listen to what the verse 11 says. Come, you children, listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. Who is the man who desire life? Who loves many days or many good? Let him come. Verse
13.
The Bible says, keep your tongue from evil. Keep your tongue from evil. Be careful, beloved. Hallelujah. And your lips from speaking deceit, depart from evil, and do good, seek peace, and pursue it. Verse 15, the Bible says, because the eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ear speaking evil. Your cry will bring results. And it's about to bring results. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the face of the Lord is against those who do evil.
If
you continue to do evil, not pastor mistake.
I
just preach the word of God. If God is for you, who can be against you? Sickness is against you. But if God is for you, sickness is not greater than God. That trouble is not greater than God. Are you understanding me? That means in any trouble, in any famine, even what will happen last night, because of your pride, you know how to use your mouth. That God came to you, something will happen. Church of God will wake up. Verse 17. Because the Bible says the righteous cry out, and the Lord hear, and deliver them out of all. Tell your neighbor all the
troubles.
Can you stand up well? Hallelujah. You know why I command you to stand? Because right now, God is about to do something. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's in the book of James, chapter 1, verse 17. It's where I conclude and take it as a revelation and let it become very serious from this wonderful day. James, chapter
1.
Verse 17. The Bible says, every good gift, long life is good, healing is good, prosperity is good, good wife is good. I'm not saying go wrong, bad wife. Because there is people that have some wrong wife. You must have a good wife. The one you can enjoy, you forget the wife. From above and come down from the Father of the light. Let me tell you, anything that you have does not come from the Father of the light. Don't call it good. It can kill you. Are you understanding me? But the Bible says good and perfect come where? From the Father of the light. Promotion, elevation, that not come from where? East, the south. It came from where? We have been connected here from above. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Start already to pray.